it's called Hempstead. And the story, I played in the Bluebell Inn there, and the Bluebell Inn, as it turns out, was the birthplace of the highwayman Dick Turpin. And the landlord of the place sort of threw down a challenge for me to write the true story of Dick Turpin. You probably know other spurious tales based on Dick. Well, this is, as far as I know, I looked at the gallows notes and did some research, and as far as I know, this is the true story. But there's one little piece I've kept in, which is, as you probably know, Dick supposedly, after having murdered two men in Epping, was supposed to have ridden from Epping in London to York overnight on a single horse, a distance of 200 miles. I tell that story in Somerset, and there's a lot of shaking of heads. So I think it's unlikely, but rather than spoil a good story with the truth, I've left Black Bess in. Otherwise, this is the story of Dick Turpin.
Oh, Lizzie loved a highwayman. She gave him all a young girl can, and in return he gave her a widowhood. From the bell at Hempstead, born to trade, a butcher's axe and a butcher's blade, and his childhood bride the picture made complete. But Lizzie's mother understood that boy would come to nothing good, an apprenticeship in bone and blood won't lead my girl to motherhood. Didn't he look fine in church today? In his buckled boots and his fustian coat, and his feathers blue and grey. Young Richard joined the Gregories, all Essex boys the lowest thieves. They robbed both rich and poor for greed and gain. They broke into their homes at night, regardless of their means or might. They'd rape or scold or set alight those poor souls who put up a fight. No honor bound those desperate men. They robbed both enemies and friends. They sold their souls for liberty and gold. But Lizzie's dreams of home gave way to cold nights in a forest cave, to a husband who she couldn't keep, who killed his friend and ran away. On a stolen coal black mare called Bess, they say. By a full moon's arc, he rode to York, 200 miles away. Changed his name, he robbed a deer and a horse and game, and left his father to take the blame to jail. Till one day the landlord's bird he blew, the landlord cried, "Dear, kind of you," and again the drunk his pistol drew, saying, "Let me charge and I'll shoot you too." From his prison cell he sent a note to his brother, and inside he wrote, "Find men who stand good witness to my name." But he wouldn't pay the postage due. The letter fell to one who knew the writing of the one whose fame had brought the Turpin House to shame. Didn't he look fine in court today? In his buckled boots and his fustian coat, and his feathers blue and grey. Dick Turpin made five men to mourn. In new coat and shoes stepped out the door. Like a gentleman he bowed along the way. He stepped up to the hangman's gate, felt his leg begin to shake. He stamped the fear, and with his friend the hangman, half an hour he spent. And with a proud and noble air, he leapt from that three-legged mare. And for a while he dangled free, his feathers kissed by morning air. but mother, didn't he swing well today? With his buckle boots and his fustian coat and his feathers blue and grey. When the town was fast asleep, the body snatchers stole his corpse away. But an angry crowd, friends to his fame, in preservation of his name, saved him from the butcher's blade and laid to rest the highwayman. They gave his ring and handsome clothes away, and another woman's tears fell on his feathers blue and grey.